play that I want to tell you about is that Romeo and Juliet. Now, there is a real thing. It's a story about how this boy and girl was in love of one another, don't you see? It is. And everything would have been all right for them, except that their daddies didn't get along. They didn't. And when the play opens, Juliet's daddy is throwing this big fancy dress ball, and he invited the whole town to be there, but he didn't invite none of Romeo's people to come. And his buddies learnt of it, and they put him up to slipping on a costume and slipping in at this party. And he was a spunky kind of a boy, and he done it. I think. He done it, and he got in there, and everything was going good. Till all of a sudden, this girl, Juliet, come down the stairs. And he was so struck by her that he give a soliloquy right there. He did. And it wasn't about being or not being. It was about doing or not doing. Well, the do's, they won out over the don'ts. And so what he done, he got her by the hand and started to take her out in the yard. And we'll never know what it was that there's going to do out there. We won't, because this fella Tybalt recognized Romeo for who he was and come up on him a-trying to pick a fight. But Juliet's daddy, he didn't want no bloodshed right there in his living room. He didn't, so all he done, he run Romeo off. But Romeo didn't go straight home. No, he didn't. He went out and hid in the yard till everybody left the party. And then when they had all went, he popped up and looked around. And he seen this light come on away off yonder. And he says to himself, he says, hark. He says, what light by yonder window shines? He did. And let me tell you, Juliet stepped out of her bedroom window onto this stoop. And she give a soliloquy. She did, friends. And somewhere in it, she says, Romeo, Romeo. She says, wherefore art thou, Romeo? And he popped up and says, I'm right here. I thank you. Well, as it happened, there was this great big pea vine growing up to where she is a-standing. And so he clumb up it. He clumb up it, and that is where they had that balcony scene. And they hadn't been there but just a few minutes till he asked her to marry him. And that shows that he was an honorable boy about it all. Well, she says, when? And he's... Well, he says, now, and that shows that he wasn't up there for no light courting. He wanted to get on with it. Back then, the reason everybody lived in castles was that there was so many of them to put up at nights. Well, there were so many of them there that they had to keep a preacher on duty day and night. Fella Friar Lawrence was his name. And so Romeo and Juliet, they went downstairs and woke him up and told him what it was that they wanted to do, and he thought that was all right. So he married them right there. But then, don't you see, it was a question of where they was to spend the night, things being how they was and all. And Friar Lawrence told Romeo that he ought to go on home that night. And Romeo, he didn't take to it too hot. He didn't. He didn't, but he did. He went on home that night, and then Romeo thought that he better go off and lay low till things cooled off. And while he is gone, friends, Juliet's mama took a great notion that Juliet ought to get married. And then she was in a bind. She was. Because she didn't want two husbands, because she figured that Romeo would be enough to take care of by himself. And so she went back down to Friar Lawrence to see what she ought to do. And he mixed her up a drink, and she drunk it, and she fell out across the bed there, and everybody thought she is dead. And they had this big, pretty funeral, and laid her out in this family tomb and all. And before that Friar Lawrence could get word to Romeo that she wasn't really dead, some of them mean boys that lived in that town told him that she was dead. And he figured life didn't hold nothing for him. So he went out and got him this big can of lye to drink. So he went over to this tomb where it was she was laid out, and he opened the door of it, and he says, "Oh, my love, oh, my wife." He did. And he went in, and he drunk the lye and kissed her and says, "With this kiss, I die." And he fell out across to there. And he was a big boy for his age. He was. And the impact of him, a falling on her, woke her up. And she woke up, didn't know what was going on, and she looked there and seen Romeo a-laying dead. And then she figured life didn't hold nothing for her. And then she took his knife and run it into herself, and she expired. She did, friends. And the moral of it is, if you've got a boy that courts a girl that you don't like, or the other way around, if you don't want the expense of a double funeral on you, the best thing for you to do is to let them have a cheap wedding.